morning, ESM, and welcome back to part two of Fall Sports Recap. Today we'll be discussing the girls' sports, but first, some news and announcements.
Caleb D. Stevens, 30, of Jefferson County, has been arrested again for faking his son's death. He collected cash on a GoFundMe from co-workers and bosses. Stevens was given 32.5 hours of bereavement time off, worth $510, as well as $1,070 in cash donations. Stevens told his co-workers and bosses that his son died of cancer on August 4th, leaving his family distraught, troopers said. The man said he had recently been scammed and could not afford to pay for his son's funeral, but state police discovered the man's son was not sick and did not die. Instead, Stevens made up the story to gain sympathy and monetary donations. Citizens of South Korea had to evacuate to underground bunkers yesterday as North Korea launched a series of 23 missiles in the country's general direction. North Korea had been firing several missiles into the Pacific Ocean for the past few weeks, but yesterday, South Korea claims they were fired with malicious intent. The United States, South Korea, and the United Nations are working to fizzle down tensions with North Korea as to avoid nuclear war. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
And to the republic for which it stands,
one nation under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
ESM DECA will be holding its second membership meeting today, November 2nd, and Thursday, November 3rd, at 325 in B4. You only have to attend one day. This gives you the option of what date to attend. We will be covering membership information, role plays, and regional events. If you have not paid your DECA dues, please bring it to the meeting. If you have any questions or cannot attend the meeting, please see Mr. Anzlin in B4 or Spartan Mart School Store. There will be a Sources of Strength meeting this Thursday, November 3rd, from 325 to 405 in the large cafeteria. All peer leaders need to attend to further discuss and plan the first Sources of Strength campaign this year. Your leadership is needed and greatly appreciated. Seniors, there are still spots available to volunteer for Kids Night Out. This will go towards your 5 hours of community service needed to graduate. Make sure to sign up on the bulletin board near the auditorium closest to the attendance booth. If you have any questions, email Mr. Hart at rhart@esmschools.org. The boys varsity volleyball team will be hosting Living Word Academy on tomorrow, November 3rd at 6 p.m. in the large gym for the semifinal round of sectionals. Anyone planning on attending must purchase tickets ahead of time using the hometown ticketing. Any student attending, please try and wear a black shirt as the theme is blackout. Any questions, please see Coach Ribzak. There will be a Spartan Junior Honor Society meeting today, Wednesday, in the large cafeteria at 3:30. Officer elections will take place, as well as a brief informational meeting. Members must be present for speeches today to vote. And there will be a mandatory meeting of the National Honor Society today in room B3. We'll be discussing Cotillion and the next blood drive. Now let's begin with girls soccer. They finished it with an incredible 16-0 undefeated season, having shut out in every game except for one. They shut out their first two opponents in sectionals before losing a close match to New Hartford in the finals. Leading the team in goals was Leah Rem with a whopping 37. Angela Polcaro led the team in assists with 27, breaking a school record held by my mother. And Isabel Chavesty had 77 saves throughout the season. Here's striker Leah Rem and midfielder Natalie Peterson with more.
So what are your plans for next season?
So, because we lost in the sectional final game again this year, my plan is probably to always be improving and to actually win a sectional title.
What was your favorite moment of the season?
My favorite moment was when we were winning against New Hartford in the finals. I mean, even though we didn't like win against them that first half, and like when I scored, you just felt the energy from the fans and from the team, and it was just something special.
What was your biggest challenge you faced in the season?
Being like prepared for every game, especially when we were on the winning streak, it was hard to like get prepared for each game and not to get overconfident, but I think we really pushed through and had a good season.
What do you think the team did well this season?
Just the overall team chemistry of the team. I think the bond that we had really helped us succeed in every game, and just having fun in practice and just overall team chemistry.
As of right now, are you or anyone else on the team planning on playing in college?
Right now, I'm planning on playing at Catawba College in North Carolina, and Isabel, our goalie, is playing at Cortland.
The girls' cross-country team had another successful season led by Rachel Ladd, who snagged multiple wins with times under 22 minutes, and Ainsley McKenna following close behind, getting some second and third place finishes. The girls' field hockey team placed first in their league this season. Leading the girls in scoring was Allie Fernandez, and leading the team in assists was Mary Grace Godleski. Molly Comstock had an impressive 110 saves in goal, and here is junior Julia Brown with more.
Hey Julia, what's your favorite moment of the season?
My favorite moment of the season was definitely our win against Homer.
What's the biggest challenge you faced?
The biggest challenge I faced was getting sick like halfway through the season, so I missed a lot of games and stuff.
What do you think the team did best on?
I think the team did best at like really working together and like growing together throughout the season.
And what's your plans next season?
My plans next season is to really grow as a team and work on my skills and get better and hopefully like beat New Hartford.
Thank you, Julia.
I know I usually talk about good news stories happening within the ESF community, but I just couldn't resist the opportunity to talk about this meme that I saw on the internet yesterday. Somebody edited the Goodyear blimp, which visited Syracuse this past weekend, into the Parkway Bridge. As you know, a lot of trucks hit the Parkway Bridge, which one just did recently, so somebody thought it would be funny to edit the blimp crashing and deflating underneath the bridge.
The girls' tennis team had a great season with multiple athletes qualifying for sectionals. Here is senior Margaret Matting and junior Maya Boots with more.
What is your favorite moment of the season?
My favorite moment was probably when we went to Wendy's after our Fulton game. It was just, I don't know, it was really funny and I enjoyed that time.
What was the hardest challenge you faced?
The hardest challenge we faced was the rain. All of our games kept on being rescheduled and even some of our games got canceled, so that sucked.
So this was my first year playing tennis, so I think that just adjusting and like using like different muscles that I would use from like the other sports that I've played was probably the most difficult adjustment.
What do you think the team did the best and what do you think the team did the worst?
I think we all had really good chemistry. I can't think of a time where I was upset with anyone on the team. I think something we all struggled with was communication like on the court, which I think every team has that.
And what are your plans for next season?
Just to keep improving, like really listen to coaches critiquing and still just like keep bonding with everyone new, because I think team bonding is the most important to a successful season.
The girls' gymnastics team had another great season as well, posting strong performances in every meet and having multiple athletes qualify for sectionals as well. Here's senior Aaliyah Thomas and freshman Allie Graham with more on the season.
What was your favorite moment from the season?
My favorite moment was probably going to Panera after a very long away meet.
My favorite moment was the bus rides home from the away meets and blasting music.
What was the hardest challenge you faced?
Probably fighting my coach to not do all of the events that he wanted me to.
I think my hardest challenge was just getting through the season and like learning new skills.
What do you think the team did the best and then the worst?
We were really good about getting a new high score each meet, but we also just were very lazy this season.
I think we were really good about cheering each other on at meets, but I think we could boost each other up during practice more.
For a senior, what do you plan to pursue outside of high school?
Probably working and trying to move out, and I most likely will go to college after I could save up money for it.
And for non-senior, what is your plan for next season?
My plan for next season is just to get more skills, I guess, and higher scores.
That's it.
What are some of the more skills you keep talking about?
My biggest goal is probably the backhand spring on beam.
Philadelphia Phillies took a 2-1 lead over the Houston Astros in a 7-0 victory in Game 3. Bryce Harper opened the scoring with a 2-run home run in the first. And I'm Bailey with your sports.
Thank you guys for tuning in to recognize the athletic success of your fellow peers these past 2 days. Remember, for those interested in signing up for a winter sport, Family ID is open now. And with that, I'm Luke. Have a great day.